My name is Julia Marie Kane, and I'm 16.
I'm Kayla Ruth, and I'm 16.
I'm Cody Ruth, and I'm 20.
God, 13.
13.
Cow.
What's your name?
Dylan Lewis Papier.
Dylan Lewis Papier.
I am here at NIH because I have a disease called Niemann Pick disease. It builds up cholesterol in my brain that causes me to forget things a lot. It causes me to not walk right.
She was just so clumsy. She ran into things. She bruised really easily.
He had jaundice.
In the struggles in school for both Cody and Kayla.
October 7th, 2011. She was 11 years old and in the sixth grade. And
they diagnosed within 6 weeks of each other.
He was, I think, 2.5, but it took a while, which is not unusual for such a rare disease.
NPC is a very rare inherited condition. It's estimated that only 500 people in the world are affected. And it's inherited, so it's the result of a genetic defect that can pass through families. It's most devastating to the central nervous system in the brain. The disease ultimately steals the ability to walk and to talk and to swallow. It causes memory loss and cognitive problems and seizures.
Well, we were part of a natural history study with Dr. Denny Porter here, and that's been Dylan's favorite. Dylan loves Dr. Porter, and that's been several years. When they figured out the cyclodextrin may be a viable drug to treat NPC, they asked us to be involved in the trial.
Hey, Dylan.
The animal model work was very exciting from a very early point. It tripled the lifespan in some of the animals and prevented the onset of neurological symptoms. So. It was pretty apparent very quickly that this drug was an exciting option. But it also became apparent that at doses that were effective at treating the disease, it caused significant hearing loss.
The disease is going to take her hearing slowly. So if we have a chance of prolonging her life or, you know, giving her a full life and the hearing is what we have to sacrifice for that, you know, there are all kinds of sign language classes out there. You know, it's not the worst thing in the world.
We started the trial with a lot of, we don't know what this is going to do, good, bad, or indifferent.
Yeah.
It was an easy decision, right?
Huh?
Easy decision.
So we knew coming into the first phase one clinical trial, bringing this drug to humans, that hearing loss was going to be a major issue.
Kaylee, on the other hand, when she heard she would be getting hearing aids or tested, she couldn't wait.
I don't mind wearing them. I can hear everything. People are talking behind my back, I can hear them.
And when she first got them, we really, I guess, didn't realize how much she was missing. But one of the first days when she put them in, she came in and she said, "Mom, guess what I heard this morning?" I said, "What?" She said, "I heard the birds outside while I was getting dressed." And I'm like, "You couldn't hear the birds outside before?" She said, "No, not when I was inside."
The preliminary data look very good. Ambulation, cognition, speech have all significantly slowed progression compared to untreated kids from the natural history study. And if we go back and look at that total disease severity score, and the average predicted amount of change that we would expect in untreated children, and compare it against our kids who've gotten cyclodextrin, we see that the kids who are getting cyclodextrin are not progressing at the same rate. And that score actually still has hearing included in it. If we take hearing out, it looks even better.
Since we got this treatment, before he used to aspirate, and he doesn't anymore.
I've had people say, "Your kids are so close," and I think, how could they not be with what they're going through?
That's right.
He's always been the sweetest kid before and after. He hasn't changed. He's very loving. He's not about birthday presents. He's about people.
I know that everybody has the best interests of the kids in their sights.
Do they get you cookies?
No.
They don't? You don't get cookies from Dr. Porter and Nicole?
No.
Yes, you do.
I do.
Yes, you do.
I mean, let's be honest. MPC didn't have a cure before this. And it's not even a cure for sure. But we have hope that it'll do some good.